Hello, ladies and gentlemen. It's Michael from Love on the Spectrum. I'm appearing right before you in this clip as we speak.
Hi, I'm Chloe from Love on the Spectrum.
Hi, my name is Maddie.
Hello, I'm Mark.
My name is Kermit.
I'm Olivia from Love on the Spectrum.
My name is Andrew.
Yes.
I'm Shane.
Hello,
Jimmy. I'm Thomas. She says she's Ruth. We're from Love on the Spectrum. Since the show, we got married. Hooray! We've been able to move out of the unit we were renting and into this house here, right next to the railway, which I'm really enjoying.
I'm looking at moving out with Bodie sometime. But me and Bodie, we're best friends. We're still really, really close.
I actually have a job now, so it's this doggy daycare, like people dropping their dogs for the day or a couple of overnighters, which is a bit difficult because I've never had a job before.
My job and role is an administration support officer, so I just make sure that the office is run smoothly.
Yeah, I'm still acting. Our theatre did go into lockdown, but we continued through the power of the internet and on Zoom chats.
I draw my own pictures. This is Naruto holding up a gold medal for the Tokyo Olympics.
I've been doing movies and book reviews on Facebook sometimes, which is pretty exciting.
When I'm not working, I spend pretty much most of my time at home, either watching television or doing acting in my bedroom. I call it my quarters. Because with the acting thing, that is actually my passion.
I'm still looking for love because it's something that's worth fighting for. You know, everyone feels like they get to that point where they're like, I'm never going to find love. Am I going to be alone for the rest of my life? Just remember, don't give up.
It's going to be hard and it might take a lot of time, but I really want to find, you know, someone and have a very special connection with them, like Jimmy, Shanae. But
how does it feel to be married? Let's wait for the train.
All right.
Oh, little Amy. Here we go.
She's now too big to be on my glasses, so I just have her around my shoulders.
I haven't given up on that. I have no intention of giving up. I am on one dating app. Decided to simply give it a try. If my future wife is watching this right now, I will happily tell her this. She will be in for a happy, healthy marriage.
I'm actually going to move on and then start applying for those social groups or speed dating events again.
And I'm considering looking into dating women for the first time because people don't know this, but it wasn't shown on the show, but I'm actually bisexual.
My favorite memory from the whole experience was meeting Dawn Wells at Supernova.
I think the funniest part, I think this one's on my behalf, I said to Mark, let's dine and dash. He got a laugh at that. That was a very funny one for me.
Maybe we should just like dine and dash. What do you reckon?
Oh, no. Going to the museum, being at the zoo and having dinner out. Yeah, it was really magical times.
You're a really special girl, Ruth. You're very different and very unique. I did enjoy the date we went on because that was some very tasty snacks.
I think meeting Lotus, like, you know, the first date we had, that was possibly one of the best moments of my life.
Yeah, it'd be cool to see you again if you're interested in that.
I would really like that.
Oh, really?
Really?
Okay, cool.
I would already work. I didn't know if you liked me.
I was worried too, but that's great. Ready. Thank
nice
you. See
you.
Ya.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Being on the show, you know, just getting used to being in the company of women, trying to like learn about things that you should and should not do on a date. And while in the presence of like other people, you know, it's helping me to stay calm and focused and built up my confidence.
It was just like going out on the dates themselves, because that's something I've just like never done before, so it was a whole new thing for me.
Dating a bisexual adult, like, it's hard as it is, but being on the spectrum, I think it just makes it a lot harder, because obviously I have trouble with reading people's emotions and body language.
First off, it was a bit of nerve-wracking, a bit of personal space, but after a couple of times here, I got used to it.
The most challenging part was trying to keep a conversation flowing, because I ran out of conversation topics.
It was a fun thing to do, getting together and having a talk 50-50.
I figured out that I need a creative person.
It hasn't been easy, but now from where I am right now, I'd say I've done extremely well, and everyone's, you know, proud of me of how far I've come.
My 5 goals for the future are, but not in order, buying a house, getting a cat, becoming a husband, becoming independently wealthy, and establishing myself an acting career. Voice acting, actually. Hey, where are you going?
To my job!
You have a job?
Why wouldn't I? I'm not some lazy, inconsiderate jerk who lays in bed all day.
Say, where can I get one of these jobs?
Oh, they're everywhere. Especially if you're green and have 6 tentacles.
Thanks. I'm gonna go look for one so I can stop mooching off my friends and they can get back to their lives.
I'm still working on getting my dream job, which is support worker and sign language interpreter.
I'm going to look at going to driving school around here so I can look at getting my L's and stuff. I kind of decided to focus on getting a job first. So that was the focus this year, and it's happened. So next year I'm going to take a look at driving classes.
I'm still working towards my dream of being a successful actress.
My dream is to get a new job at Australia Post, to gain more customer service in a positive way. That means I could look after people.
I think you feel a bit funny. I think you'll just look at the path and be like, well, I love you. Like, you are amazing. I just want, you know, spend the rest of my life with you.
Like, happiness, friendly, warmth as well.
I'm not really sure what it feels like. I see it, when I feel all the time, because when I'm with Shanae.
Well, it's hard to say. Complicated.
It's complicated. People just think it's all so black and white. It can be a bit all over the place sometimes.
It just sweeps you off into a magical realm of adventure.
Feels like I'm safe. Yeah, safety.
Love makes you feel very warm and fuzzy on the inside. And it makes you feel great as a person. And it kind of makes you feel like that you have a purpose in life. These ducks are a symbol of love and relationships. Set them side by side to strengthen and bind a loving relationship. If you are single and seeking love, sit them facing each other beside your bed, and love is sure to come your way.